Hey there, I'm Adi Osmani. I'm a developer programs engineer on the Chrome team at Google. And today we're going to talk about some new Chrome DevTools features spanning workspaces, snippets, and an improved Sass debugging workflow. Now these features are going to hopefully help improve your authoring and productivity in the tools, so let's dive right in. The typical web app development workflow usually involves a clever window arrangement of having your editor and the browser with your DevTools living side by side and constantly making this sort of cumbersome context switch between these tools. Now, rather than having to do that, wouldn't it be great if you could spend a little bit more of that time that you're editing files on directly inside the DevTools so that you could both debug and edit your project files? Now, I'm going to talk about Workspaces, which is a new feature we've enabled to facilitate this workflow. So I currently have an application open at sort of a page level right now. And what I want to do is actually be able to go and open up and edit my entire project. So everything that makes up this project on my local file system. And the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to go and I'm going to add this application, HTML5, please, locally. You should now be able to see that I have two sets of directories. I have my page level view of this page and then my entire project level view. And I want to be able to consolidate these so that whenever I make a change, they apply to both what Chrome is able to display and what I'm able to experience during debugging and what I'm, the changes that I'm making to my original source files. So I'm going to go and I'm going to right click on any file really inside my project. I'm going to go and I'm going to map them to file system resource. And I'm just going to choose the option which basically maps it back to the original source file. Chrome DevTools is going to ask me to restart. It's gone and it's done that. And now you see I just have one single view. This one view consolidates everything and it basically represents my entire project and all the files that make up my whole application. And I can go and I can edit, I can edit my index file, I can edit any of my build files, I can go and I can edit my JavaScript. And the first thing I want to do is I want to make sure that in this new workspace world, I'm still able to do things like live edit and live debug and use my breakpoints. So let's do that. I want to locate a specific method called update search, and I'm going to do that using a keyboard shortcut called Command Shift O, and it's called update search. So I've typed that in, and it's gone and it's taken me there. And what I'm now going to do is I want to change this application so that so the current way that this works is I type in a tag, so it can be video, audio, canvas, or another HTML5 feature, and this page will basically let me know whether it's safe or not to use that feature. What I want is whenever I type into the search field, I basically want it to log to the console. And so I'm going to add a little console log statement here. I'm going to say console log, we're updating. And I'm going to do command save just to save that back. And using the escape shortcut key, I'm going to open up a local console, which can be displayed at the same time as the sources panel, so I can see my output. And what I now want to see is whenever I type in something, as you can see, that's logging correctly to the console, which is great. So I know that live editing seems to be working fine. The next thing I want to be able to do is work with breakpoints. So we can still use update search for this. Let me add a breakpoint to class list, and I can do this by clicking inside the line number gutter. And I can do that inside a few other places in my code. And what I'm now going to do is basically go back to here and start typing it again. And the first thing you'll notice is that it's triggered that first breakpoint. And I can go and I can continue on to the next breakpoint just by right-clicking inside the gutter and clicking on the next one going to continue here, which will continue execution up to that point. And I can continue to the next one right after that if I want to. So let's kill the stuff that we had in console. There at the moment. Now, something that I noticed with Workspaces that's actually pretty cool is the ability for DevTools. Let me show you this. I'm gonna close my script file. I'm gonna close the DevTools. So let's assume that we've restarted Chrome. I'm gonna open up my sources panel once again, and I'm gonna go back to script.js, which is what we were working on. And what you'll now see is that all of those breakpoints that I created are actually still there. The DevTools have been able to remember them. And it can do that for any number of files. I can have a bunch of different scripts that are composing my application, and it'll basically remember the different breakpoint settings for them. I can actually go and, I can still add things like conditional breakpoints as well. So here, what I want to do is say, if the value of search.value is panda, for example, I basically want it to trigger this breakpoint. So I can type in audio and nothing happens, but I type in panda and it's triggered that conditional breakpoint. I can actually, so let's continue working through there, and let's get rid of that conditional breakpoint. And let's take a look at our watch expressions. So I can still add things like, you know, objects to my watch expressions and have those be watched during my workflow. So pretty much everything works the same way that you'd expect it to. Now, if we're saying that, you know, you're getting a slightly better editing experience inside the DevTools, one thing that we commonly need to do is have access to some sort of revision history. Now, you actually get access to this by right-clicking on any file, going to the context menu, and then clicking on local modifications. And what this will do is, and let's make some modifications. Let's say, you know, var test equals some object. Let's save that. And what you can see is that I get a complete revision history where I can go and revert back all the changes that I've made up to a certain point. I can apply a specific change at a particular timestamp if I want. Or I can apply a specific revision to my original files. And this is really useful. So rather than having to sort of worry that a change that I'm making during my live editing and debugging workflow is going to come back to bite me later, I can easily, you know, trust local modifications to save those changes, and I can go and I can revert back to them if needed. So I'm going to escape that. Now you can actually get some nice mileage using some of the other buttons that are at the bottom of the sources panel. So let's take a look at some of those. Now it's quite common, you know, when you're working on an application of some sort, to have a few files that are minified, and these may be outside of your own build process. So maybe it's like a minified version of jQuery or Backbone or something else, and you just want to make it a little bit more readable, because the minified form of this file is just not that easy to work with. So using the curly braces button at the very bottom, this one that says pretty print, I can click on that, and it'll go and it'll beautify my JavaScript for me. So I can go, and this is a little bit more easy to read. It's much more neatly white-spaced out. It's a lot more easy for me to go through. And I can go and I can use, although, you know, some of these variable names are going to be minified, I can actually mostly still use my same shortcut for displaying all of these methods to access things, which is great. Now, if you're working on a project which has really any number of large files on it, you're going to want to be able to easily locate things, whether it be inside a specific file or across your entire project. Now, there are some useful keyboard shortcuts which can help you achieve this, and I'm going to go through some of them right now. So we've already gone through one of them, which is finding a method in a specific file. So for any of the shortcuts I'm going to go through, I'll probably be using the Mac-specific version, which uses Command. But if you're on Windows or you're on Linux, you can use Control instead of Command to achieve the exact same thing. So if I want to locate a specific method inside a file, if I want to filter down to a specific method, or in the case of a style sheet, a specific property, I can use Command-Shift-O. And like earlier, I can filter down to update search. I can filter down to pretty much any method I want. And by clicking on it, it'll take me to the line number where that method or function exists, which is great. Another thing I might want to be able to do is open or filter the list of files that are available inside a project. And I can do that with Command-O. So this will go and it will display all of the different files that I have available to me. If I'm looking for my style file, I can start typing. And as you can see, it's filtered down to the list to those results that are relevant to me. If I'm looking for all of my JavaScript files, I can just type in .js and achieve the exact same thing, which is, again, quite helpful. Now, if I want to navigate to a specific line that I know exists inside my file, you can use Command plus L to achieve this. So here I'm going to go to line number 56. And as I can see, I'm in the region of my update search method once again, which is really great. Now, some of the different panels inside the DevTools have their own find feature, which works at a context level on the material that you're working on. So in the case of the sources panel, Command F will bring up a nice little search box at the very bottom, near the sources toolbar at the very bottom of the screen. And I can start typing in here to locate things inside this file. So I can find my update search once again using this. I can find specific variable names or pretty much anything that I want. And I can use these navigation toggles to go back and forth between different search results. I can actually also go and find and replace different content if I want to, the same way that I would in a normal text editor, which can be useful. Now, this type of functionality is present on a few different panels, including network and, I believe, resources as well. So if you're using those panels, you can also use Command F on them. Typically, we also need to be able to search across all of the files that form a project. And we can do this using another keyboard shortcut, which is Command Option F. And what this gives me is the ability to look across every single file in my project. So let me look for something like document. I want to see what files in this project use the word document in them. And as you can see, it's giving me a list of all the different files, as well as the line numbers where these occurrences are. And I can go and I can click on any result, and it'll actually open it up inside the source panel editor. And I can go and I can make any changes that I want to those files quite easily. So you can expand any of these search results, and it'll give you a preview of where it's found, the instance of what you've been looking for. And this feature also supports some nice things like regular expressions if you want to use those. So let's hit Escape again to kill the console. Now that's great. I'm able to pretty much edit files directly inside the DevTools. I can load up local projects, entire projects, so I can see all the different files. And if I close Chrome or close the DevTools, that project, as long as I want it to be, will still be around, so I don't have to go manually opening up any individual files that I want to debug or edit. So that's great. Now, if you'd like to start using Workspaces today, the first thing you're going to need to do is make sure you're using Google Chrome Canary, so the Canary release channel. The next thing you want to do is go to About Flags and look for the Developer Tools Experiments. So I'm looking for Developer Tools, and you just want to make sure that you enable Developer Tools Experiments and then relaunch Chrome. The next thing you want to do is go to the Settings pane once you've fired up DevTools, go to Experiments, and enable File System Folders in Sources panel. So this option that I have open right here. You then need to relaunch your Developer Tools, and you'll get access to a new feature called Workspace that appears as a tab. And you can then go and add as many different file systems as you want, and you can have some configuration options around sort of the different file mappings that are also set. And that's it. You should be able to work with projects directly inside the tools, which can be nice. Sometimes you want to be able to save smaller scripts, utilities, and bookmarklets so they're always available to you inside the DevTools. There's a new feature that can help you with this called snippets. So to use snippets, go to the Sources panel, and in the left-hand nav, find the Snippets subbar. Now in the tree view here, you can see that I already have some snippets that I created earlier. To create a brand new snippet, right-click inside the tree view and hit New. You can then customize the name of your snippet to be pretty much whatever you want. In my case, I'm going to call it cornify.js. You can then paste in the contents of a bookmarklet or write any custom script that you want to form your snippet. In my case, I'm going to paste in my cornify script, and I can then run this against any local object if I want, so the window, the navigator, and so on, but I'll mostly be using this against the current page. Now there are two ways that you can execute a snippet. You can either use the triangular button at the very bottom of the sources bar, which will basically go and run it, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Control-Shift-E, which will also do the same thing. So in our case, we're going to use Control-Shift-E to run my snippet. And what you can see is it's gone and it's added a really, really awesome rainbow to my page. Now I can go and I can run this once again. Boom, I've got a unicorn. This page is so much more functional now. And that's great. As you can see, I can actually go to any script here. So I can go to CSS Prettifier, which I'll be showing you in a moment. But I can add breakpoints to this page. I can treat this as pretty much any normal script. I can live edit it. I can live debug it. And that's great. Another nice thing about this feature is that it basically gives you access to a lovely multi-line console with both syntax highlighting and persistence. So you can basically go and, you know, do anything you want and hit the next line, keep editing this in the same way that you would any other script, which is great. Now, to show you another example of a bookmarklet, I created CSS Prettifier. And I'm currently on a page, so normally when you're, you know, view sourcing a page, you might be trying to check out the JavaScript on that page or the CSS. And when you try going and looking at the raw version of that, it's not very easy to do that always, because sometimes those style sheets might be minified and that those scripts might be minified too. So in this case, what I'm going to do with CSS Prettifier is I'm just going to go and I'm going to run this against the current page. And as you can see, it's gone and it's prettified my CSS, making it much more readable, much more accessible to me, which is great. So snippets have got a lot of capabilities. You can use all the same panels as you would for your debugging and editing workflows, as we were looking at earlier with Workspaces. And to enable them and start using snippets today, all you need to do is go to the Settings cog, go back to Experiments, and just check Snippet Support. Now, at the current time, snippets are still experimental. We're expecting them to sort of come out of experiments quite soon. So you may not even need to enable them in the future, and that's the hope. So we've looked at workspaces, we've looked at snippets. The next thing we're going to look at is an improved Sass debugging workflow inside the DevTools. If you enjoy working with an abstraction language like Sass, your workflow inside the DevTools has probably been a little bit limited. The reason is, although you can edit CSS inside the Sources panel or by the Elements panel, none of the changes that you make will actually go and be propagated back to your original Sass source files. And that means that as soon as you run the Sass compiler, any changes made to your CSS from the DevTools will be overwritten. That workflow changes now with some recent improvements that we've made. I'm going to go over to the Elements panel, and inspecting the top root of their HTML5 Please page, I'm going to go and take a look at some of our styles. So here I see background color 232927. Now I can actually command and click into this color and be taken to the dark variable name, which expresses what this color is, which is fantastic. Going back to Elements, I can actually also command click on background color to be taken to the reference where we're saying, okay, we'll use the dark variable for this color, which is great. I'm going to go and I'm now going to inspect the H1 for this page, so HTML5, please. And what you'll notice in the side is that rather than us referring to style.css or just the CSS, we're actually now referring to line numbers for the original Sass source files. So I can go and by clicking on style.scss, it will actually take me to the line source for this style, which is great. And I can now go and start making actual changes to these. I have another feature called on, which basically allows me to reload whenever changes are made to my Sass files, and I'm going to preview what that looks like right now. So I now want to make a change to one of my Sass source files. There's actually a Sass function that I defined earlier called OMG, and I'd like to change my text shadow to use that instead of what we got at the moment. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to text shadow, I'm going to type in OMG, let's clean up some of this stuff, and I'm just going to command S and take a look at this. Boom. So what that's done is it's actually gone and compiled my Sass file into CSS, and it's being previewed inside of Chrome without me having to go and use any additional tools separately. So I do have my Sass compiler running in the background and watching everything, but that's about it. Now, in order to enable this Sass editing workflow, you need to go to DevTools Settings, go to Experiments, and first of all, make sure you have support for Sass checked. After that, you'll probably have to relaunch the tools, but next go to General, scroll down, and you want to enable Source Maps as well as the Auto Reload CSS upon Sass Save. And that's what basically allows us to reload without having to go and do anything extra like refresh the page manually. Finally, make sure that you're running the Sass compiler with some specific flags in the background. In this case, we're using Sass, Watch, SCSS, Source Map, and then defining the input and output for our files. And that's it. If you'd like to stay on top of the latest news to do with the Chrome DevTools, please feel free to follow us on Plus on the Google Chrome Developers channel. On Twitter, you can catch us on Chromium Dev, or you can watch our regular show, The Breakpoint, which captures the latest and greatest in the world of tooling. Until next time, thank you and goodbye.